Well, good morning. Welcome to Debbie's Back Porch. So glad to have you with us. You may have noticed I make a fair amount of fresh cheese, but I wanted to start making some aged cheese. And you have to have a press for that. And oh my, have you ever priced a cheese press? So I figured it could be made cheaper, and I did a little searching. My son Jim helped me get everything to put together. These are the parts we used. Now, there are lots and lots of tutorials for making this, but I thought that I would show you a few lessons learned and that you might find that helpful. And I hope you'll give us a thumbs up and subscribe and click the little bell icon at the top right. You'll get a notice when I post new videos about twice a week. I'm going to start here with a 24-inch 1x6, and I've got some bolts and nuts and washers there. We drilled four holes, one in each corner. The first lesson learned is use an 18-inch board. Having it 24 inches long makes it difficult to line up the bolts with the holes in the top. And 18 inches would be sufficient. So I'm just hand tightening these nuts. You see I put the nuts on the top and the bottom and washers on the top and the bottom. Now you'll want some kind of a cheese mat, and there are lots of different things, but you want something to force the liquid to drain off. That's just a piece of plastic I had. Then you need a cheese mold, and that varies based on the type of cheese you're going to make. It has holes all around it. It's food grade plastic. And for now, I'm just putting some dish towels in here to show you how this works, and then you put the follower on. You can make this, but I bought it. It's the most expensive part of the whole thing. Now, a can of, this is a can of peaches, will fit right down under that follower, and then I'm going to put the top board on. And with the 24-inch boards, it's kind of hard to line them up. But here's another lesson learned. Make these holes much bigger than the bottom ones, because you want your top board to move up and down freely, because you want your weight to come from the weights that you put on top, not from resistance on the bolts. So you can see that moves up and down now. I did have to make the holes a bit bigger, and I'm going to make them bigger still. Then I have four half-inch wing nuts that I'm going to put here, but I'm not going to snug them down yet. So then you want to add the weight, and I have just one brick in here right now. This brick is about 4 pounds. It will take a lot. I may find another kind of weight, but you want to even it up and put it right on top of the cheese mold. And this would take 8 or 9 bricks, and I can just spread them out across to the right weight. Cheddar cheese takes up to 50 pounds. So that's a lot of bricks, so I may have to rethink that. So you're going to snug these down, and as I said, you need to make these holes a little bit bigger because you don't want the weight to come from the wing nut pressure. You want it to come from the actual measured weight, and I can just spread the bricks along here. I got lots of bricks, but as I say, I may rethink that. So this is pretty much it. The only thing I would add is that you want to put something underneath it to catch the flow of the liquid that comes off. I think this turned out pretty well. I'm getting ready to make some cheddar cheese here pretty soon. Thank you for joining us on Debbie's Back Porch. Hope to see you again tomorrow.